Ah, Dad.
What are you doing?
What is all this? Eh?
What?
So you think all the money I spent in training you to the university fell from the sky? Is that what you think, Stanley?
Dad, what is the meaning of this?
Go out there and find a job for yourself.
What do you think I'm doing, Dad? I mean, look at this. This is a Tuesday's word.
And so what?
And so what? And so everything. I mean, a job you do not find in the dailies is not worth going out for.
Keep on deceiving yourself. Look at it. Let me tell you, if you don't know, there are no more jobs on the pages of newspapers. Did you hear that?
Dad, why are you talking like this? Huh?
Because I am over 60. And I've spent all the minutes of these years here in this country. When the game is Nigeria, the rules change.
Dad?
Of course, there are no rules at all. Politics, any game, entertainment, every other thing, all turned upside down.
Dad, you know, you were once a director of the ministry.
Fine. You know that. And that is why I have seen it all. Listen, young boy, go out there, find yourself a job. Sitting down here reading papers means wasting my money. Did you hear that?
Igwe.
Yes, sir.
The interview panel recommended you based on your credentials.
That's very good to hear, sir.
This is not a one-man fair.
I don't understand.
I mean, we have interests to protect, telephone calls to respect, and instructions to obey.
I can't assess him to
The truth is, the advert you saw in the papers were mere academics. Am I communicating? You have to look elsewhere.
I was...
Good day, Mr. Igwe. What are you still doing here?
It's not a matter of shouting. It's not.
I'm so sick and tired of this country.
You see, what an old man sees sitting down, a young man cannot see it standing atop a mountain.
You're so wrong, old man. And I'm going to prove it. Get like 100 naira from you for transportation.
Where to? Another futile interview.
Dad, this is the Bible. I'm going to church.
But you shouldn't be going to church at this time.
Every time is for God, Dad.
Oh, every time is for God?
Yes.
Because you eat my food, you drink my water, you live in my house and enjoy almost everything free from a dad who labored, trained you up for a change of guard, then what do I get in return from you? A lazy graduate who is so timid to face the realities of life.
Papa. Stanley.
Stanley, you are a disgrace. You really are.
Have to be that blunt, do you?
God, what diplomatic language have I not used for my only child?
to reason.
No, no, no. That was too harsh. That was too harsh.
You think so? I'm just beginning. Very soon, I will invent the dictionary for more penetrating words for him.
And you think that will solve any problem?
Of course.
No, it will not. It will aggravate it.
No, no, no. I don't think so.
Just watch out for the transmission that will go his way. Watch out.
Carefully,
okay? Thank you.
Take care.
Yeah, bye-bye.
Sweet girl.
Yeah, bye-bye.
Hey, tomorrow, don't be
late.
Sure, we know.
Okay.
You drive carefully. Are you doing that here?
Whatever. Bye.
Hi, Dad.
Hi, Mom.
Hello, baby sis.
Why are you called to your sister?
Daddy, this is for you.
For me?
Yes. Mom, this is for you.
Thank you, my daughter.
And yours I will keep till you learn how to respect your elders.
I don't need your ill-gotten presents anyway.
Daddy, did you hear her?
What is wrong with your daughter?
Please, don't start. She is also your daughter, Sandra.
And just what do you mean by that?
What you just heard?
Sandra, you owe your sister an apology.
An apology?
Yes.
You owe her an apology for the way you behaved to her.
Mom. Have you ever sat down to ask your dear daughter what exactly she does for a living? I mean, what business does she involve herself in?
That's exactly the reason why we should all be grateful to her for providing for all of us in this family.
Daddy, I don't care. I don't care about whatever she provides in this house. I don't care.
Who asked you to care?
Who did?
Sandra, let me ask you a question. Are you jealous of your own sister?
Mom? Jealous? For what?
Then why are you so resentful about her magnanimity in this house?
Mommy, the Lord
said... Just shush it with the Lord said.
What's that?
My dear sis, can you refresh our memories again with what you do for a living?
And how is that your business again? That's what I thought. How is that your freaking business?
Fine. And everybody should just leave me out of it. Out of it.
Okay.
Hey. Mr. Stanley. Your credentials before me are sound to the last papers.
Thank you, sir.
But believe me, working here goes beyond paper qualification.
Sir, I promise to make sure...
You don't understand, do you? 3 members of the board, half candidate each. Out of the 3, I'm growing grey hairs trying to pick up one. How then do I add you to the list?
But sir, are the other candidates more qualified than I am?
You don't get things easily, do you? I'm telling you, there's no place for you to work here. What other diplomatic language do you want me to apply to you? Please, Mr. Stanley, do have a good day. I have better things to do.
Always reading Christian books, eh?
Yes, ma'am. Just trying to feed on my conscious and subconscious mind in the ways of the Lord.
In the ways of the Lord.
Yes.
Hey, Sandra.
Yes, ma'am.
Tell me, which portion in the ways of the Lord encourages insulting and envy to your own elder sister?
Mom, I don't understand.
Hey, you don't understand. You know the condition in this family, don't you?
Dad is unemployed and you can barely support the family from your second-hand clothing business.
Exactly!
But Mom, haven't I accepted that in good faith?
Perhaps! Anyway, let's not talk about that now. Let's talk about your sister.
What about her?
You know, she got herself admission into the university.
So?
She is the one that started my second-hand clothing business.
And?
All her friends are women! For instance, Madam Jane, who is very generous, is a friend of your own sister.
Yes, Mom. Talking about this, Madam Jane, have you ever asked your daughter Pat what exactly she does for her to attract so much generosity?
What do I care? She is a woman, and her generosity is well intentioned. So, I don't care, because I know that nothing bad will ever come out from it.
Mom.
Yes.
You should care. Mom, we're talking about your daughter here. You should care so much. Mom, I am so sure that if you know what Pat does for this so-called Madam Jane to attract so much generosity, that your disgust will surpass mine in regards of this so-called generosity of hers.
Sandra, what exactly are you talking about?
Mom, please. I have a test this evening in church. I have to read.
Daughter,
yes.
You are welcome.
Thank you.
All this for me?
You're welcome,
my dear. Enjoy
yourself. Thank you so much. So, Jane, my dear, today that you have come to pay us a visit, I hope all is well.
Oh, very well, ma'am. All is well. Pat is my friend, and you know, she's very dear to me. And so you shouldn't visit. I should be the one doing the visiting. Besides, yesterday she was meant to come help me do some shopping. But then when I didn't see her, I got so worried. And that's why I had to come this morning to find out.
Why didn't you?
Mommy, you remember it was you who brought me the medicine I needed for the severe headache I had yesterday?
Oh, yes. Ah, I forgot. She had a severe headache. Yes.
Oh dear. I didn't know that.
Excuse me.
Oh, quite excuses. So, how are you feeling now?
I'm alright.
Hey, you caught the crap.
Because you and I know that there's nothing like headache.
And I tell you something, it is not your lies that bother me. It is that of your mother towing the same line. Hey, that is the problem.
Well, I think that's why she left. Probably because she was uncomfortable. Actually, there's a problem, but I'll tell you about it later. Okay?
Good morning. Madam Jane.
Sandra, how are you?
As you can see, no headache to worry about.
I see.
One of these days, somebody's going to break that girl's neck, and I'm pretty sure that will be me. Oh, please go get ready. 1 minute.
Take 100 if you want.
Such lie.
Mom, does it really matter?
It does matter, my daughter. Making your mother go through such a lie.
Well, Mom, it was either that lie or Jane keeps probing.
Are you sure it was not so obvious?
I don't care. Mom, please, I am just trying to get ready so we can go out.
It's okay. It's okay, my daughter. It's all right. Eh?
Remembered Pat having a headache. Neither did I ever remember you buying any drugs for her.
Sandra, you shouldn't eavesdrop.
Oh, is that what you call it? Eavesdropping? But if I were in your shoes, I wouldn't debase myself into telling such a lie.
Okay, you are not in my shoes, and that you must know.
Certainly. But when my daughter starts forcing me into telling such lies, I should be able to sit and think deeply why I'm being used. Generosity, my foot. Mom, Dad. I was selected as one of the 5 to be trained by the church.
Trained by the church?
Yes. You know, after the test, we were chosen for a 6-month computer program, fully sponsored by the church.
Computer program?
Yes. The easiest route to self-employment.
So?
Dad, 6 months program in desktop publishing is enough to get you whatever job you want in any company.
Well?
Well, I intend to send myself to higher institution. Here comes the breadwinner.
Sandra, are you aware that I am 3 years older than you are?
Really? As if it's enough prize to flaunt around.
Daddy, did you hear her? Daddy, you have to warn her. Mommy, listen to her. Because I will not continue to take this insult from her. Daddy, warn her. Rubbish.
Christiana, you have to talk to your daughter. You must talk to Sandra.
Dad, why will you go on condoning whatever she does in this house?
Why are you attacking her like that?
Good morning, ma'am.
Morning. Do have a seat. Here, your employment letter. Read through and sign the acceptance form attached. If you're comfortable.
100,000 naira a month? Oh my God!
That's only the basic. The allowance might well surpass that.
God, I don't believe this. I'm so lucky. Wow.
And if it's worth your while, then you have to hurry to the secretary's office, sign the dotted lines, and you'll be shown to your office.
I'm going there right away. That's just where I'm going right now. Thank you.
It takes a lot to be my personal assistant.
I'll do anything, madam. Anything.
Good.
Thank you.
Have a wonderful
day. I need to know.
Oh, see.
Pat. Patricia.
Mom, wake up and sit down. I have been thinking ever since you made me tell a lie to your friend Jane.
Mom, please, come on. Not that again. Why are you talking like an old school?
Of course I am one. For you to have made me tell such stupid lie, I have been wondering.
Mom, trust me. There's nothing to wonder about and there's nothing to worry about.
There are plenty of things to worry about. You weren't brought up that way. You were not brought up to tell lies.
Okay.
And do you know that every evil thing starts by telling lies? And I don't see any reason why you should carve one out.
Okay, Mom. Cross my heart. I'll never lie again.
Talking about your friend, Jane, what is it that you do specially for her?
Mom, what are you insinuating?
The way she came looking for you the other day. She seemed so desperate.
Mom, come on. You saw us live together. She wanted me to accompany her for shopping or something. And we left together.
But I never went to the shopping with you people, did I?
What are you insinuating?
I hope she is not using you to pay debts.
What kind of debts?
Main debts, of course.
Come on, Mom.
Of course, yes. This is Lagos. And pimping is a lucrative business. And that woman seems cut out like one.
I see that finally Sandra has money.
Leave your sister out of this.
Well, Mommy, she's not part of this conspiracy. You're just sounding like an ingrate to me. I mean, given in what Jane has done for this family and what she's still doing, and I mean.
And that is exactly why I want to find out what she gets in return by going this far.
Mom, like I said, you sound like an ingrate.
You slapped me?
Yes!
I did. Your helping out in the family does not mean that you should insult me. I am your mother.
Nobody should ask me money tomorrow for food. I'm not giving. I'm not giving.
Hello, Dad. Hello, Mom. You see Dad?
Yeah. You know, patience pays, you know.
And what is patience?
Oh, come on, Dad. You know about the patient dog getting the fattest bone? I just got a
job! Got a job?
Yes!
What kind of job is that?
Does it matter as long as it gets paid? Mm-hmm.
What kind of job?
Personal assistant to the CEO.
Personal assistant.
Mm-hmm.
So, how good is a trained accountant as a personal assistant?
Look, if it's on financial matters, it doesn't really matter.
And bottom line is that I got a job. And it pays well.
Oh, I'm so happy for
thanks,
you.
Thanks, Mom. Yes, so, it's so well paid.
How well is it?
100,000 basic. And that excludes allowances.
Mm-hmm. Are you serious?
Yes. And guess what? I resume today.
Well, that sounds
I'm so
like
happy
it.
For you.
Yes. Yes, yes, I'm so happy, Mom. You have no idea. I'm hungry. Give me food.
It's all right.
You should have seen it, man. You need to see my CEO. Very, very classic. Lovely atmosphere.
be sent for me, ma'am.
Yes. I'm gonna be working late today, say about 10 p.m. By 5 p.m., when the last staff is gone, you just do lock up everywhere and make sure you hang around for me until I'm ready to leave. Okay?
That wouldn't be a problem, madam.
I wasn't expecting him.
Okay.
Stan?
Yes, ma'am.
It takes more than official competence to be and continue being my personal assistant.
Well, I promise not to fall short, madam.
Good. Pretty soon, we're gonna start seeing. Oh, oh, oh. Oh, oh, oh. Stan, oh, oh, oh. Come into my office now.
Yes, ma'am. You sent for me.
Yeah. I'm aware you're an excellent driver.
A driver, yes, but excellent, that I cannot claim.
Oh, modesty, huh?
Well.
As my personal assistant, I would love you to be around me all the time. By the way, the extra time you're going to be spending today is going to earn you 5,000 naira.
Wow, madam, that's... Thank you, that's very generous of you.
Thank you.
Thank you very much.
You're welcome. Oh, well, my driver is going to be deployed to other official duties. And I would want you to take over. I mean, add his duties to yours. And that's going to bring the increment of your basic monthly salary to 150,000 naira.
My God. Madam, is there a limit to how you can make one do anything?
That is the idea. That is just a general idea. To make you do anything, just anything.
Very well, madam. All you need to do is just ask.
Very well then. For starters, get my jacket.
So what?
Over there, my jacket. Oh, sorry. Come on. Be gentle. Hey. Do I detect
hesitation? No, madam.
Okay, then.
Sorry.
Good. Now, take me out. Oh, my briefcase.
Level, Stanley, for Christ's sake.
Mama, I know.
Must you stay this late?
It's the official overtime.
So this is what it takes to be a personal assistant, right?
God, get this Satan behind me. Please.
I don't know when that.
my baby.
So, Sandra.
Yes, Mom.
How far would your computer school?
Well, everything is going on fine. I just have 2 months to go, then I'll be good for an operator's job.
Really? Yes. No, this is great.
That's good news.
Yes, Dad. Mom, Dad.
Yes.
Have you really asked Pat where she is?
Don't stop on my account. Ask Pat what? Just as I thought.
Cat got your tongue.
Patricia, not even greetings to your parents. Eh?
A breadwinner doesn't offer greetings to their subjects, do they?
Will you stop that?
Generous contributions.
Honestly, I find it hard to believe that in just 5 months of your being employed, we have risen so high on the social ladder.
Well, Dad, you know how it is. Everything comes to the man who waits on the Lord, right?
I think you're right there. But this your supersonic rise, my son.
Oh, Dad, come on, man. We reel with the bad times. Should we reel the good times, too?
But not at all.
Yeah, that reminds me. You said you were going to do some telling when I start work. So now I'm all ears. Tell me.
Yes, I remember. I remember I did say also that you have to be 6 months old in your job for the telling.
Dad, I'm 5 months down already. What's the difference with 1 month?
A lot can still happen in a month. A lot.
Very well. I know I wouldn't die before then.
Neither would I.
You've finally done it. I am out of your life for good.
Come off it, Pat. You know what happened.
What happened? I am asking you, Jen, what happened? I walked in on you practically begging a man for sex. He was home waiting for you only to bump in on you, practically naked, begging a man for sex. A man that is supposed to be your peer.
Stop!
Stop? Well, I am done with your deception. I know exactly what to do.
Whatever. Aren't you so early today, Stanley? Stanley.
Yes, Dad.
Is everything all right?
Everything was a charade. Everything.
What? What are you talking about?
This house, the car. Everything was all a charade to lead me astray.
Stanley, could you please tell me what is going on?
Devil's gift.
Stanley.
We're packing out of this house. I'm returning the car and I'm quitting the job tomorrow.
God. Wait? Return the car?
Yes, Dad.
Do you know the worst form of poverty? Now listen. Living poor, then rich, and then back to poverty. That last bit is the most painful thing.
Besides offending God, there is nothing I can do.
Okay. All right. Maybe it is time I told you the story that I've been keeping away from you.
You have no choice, Dad. I'm already 6 months old in my employment.
And you didn't even keep the job, did you?
I've not been sacked either, you know. If I quit tomorrow, then I'm 6 months and a day old in the job.
All right. You see, my son, it's not age. Rather, it's the loss of interest that makes you age.
Come again.
At 49, I was already an old man, very old man.
How?
I lost interest in the country called Nigeria.
That is treasonable.
Of course. What is treason, if not the way the horse rider sees it? Listen, my son. If you kill one, you are a murderer. And when you kill thousands, you are a hero.
Is it?
Yes, my dear. Take it home. You see, impertinence is often well meant.
Dad, you're going round circles.
Because I once went straight and had my fingers popped terribly. So, I was one of the youngest directors at 45. I was a director in the education ministry when the 6334 system became operational.
Oh yeah, the 6334, the charade that led our educational system to the Stone Age.
Exactly. Equipment were imported from abroad through our department in the ministry. And trying to find out whether the equipment conformed to the standards, I discovered something very funny.
How funny?
First grade intro tech equipment that was supposed to have been imported from Germany all came from China.
You don't say.
Oh yes, it wasn't just China. It came as massive production of West tool meant for destruction in the communist enclave as fallen short of standards.
That's not surprising.
But I was surprised in trying to find out why. I discovered a big fraud. A 2 billion naira fraud.
What? 2 billion naira?
2 billion naira fraud. Then I took my time. I took 2 weeks off to investigate. There was this very sharp accountant who was working under me then, one Frank Sam Udechukwu. Yes, Frank Sam Udechukwu. Now we worked days and nights trying to pierce the evil achievement.
Yeah, then?
Then I stopped the distribution of the obsolete substandard equipment to our secondary school.
Excellent!
And I wrote a report of 30 page findings to the minister for his eyes only.
Good move, Dad, good move.
So I thought. The morning I was to send the report to the minister, the DG summoned me to his office via the intercom.
Yeah, I'm sure to commend you for a job well done, I presume.
Wrong, my dear, wrong. The DG, in his worst posture of anger, tore at me like an assertion dog.
Why?
First of all, he asked me why I should stop the distribution of the equipment as ordered. Well, I told him that they were substandard and shouldn't be sent to our secondary schools.
Yeah?
He asked me if I have any of my children in the schools. And I replied him, none yet. And he asked me why I should bother myself if I had no children involved.
I can't believe that the DG was asking you such a thing.
He asked, and worse still, he asked me whose cross I was trying to bear in my saintly posture. And I replied him, I said, Zeke has always preached one Nigeria, and on that I stand. And he replied that Nigeria would not be true if I had distributed the equipment to the schools.
Terrible.
When I got to my office, I was foaming. And I remembered Sam. And I called him to my office. I asked him why and how the DG got to know about the report. Sam looked me in the face and said that he was instructed to offer me a 30 million naira bribe.
30 million naira?
Bribe.
What for?
That was what I asked him. He said I should go and tear up my report and then order for the distribution of those goods to the schools.
Oh my God.
I couldn't believe what I was hearing. I ordered him out of my office and sent my report to the minister.
Yeah, great. I'm sure he'll probably call you for a handshake.
Wrong again. The man looked me in the face and said, what a fool I was. That I saw an opportunity to enrich my family for life and I blew it. He told me that those before us stole from the national coffers and that those who will come after us will continue to steal.
I can't believe this. Such words are coming out of the mouth of a minister?
I was perplexed, my dear. I was rooted to the ground. And as a result, I got dismissed from the civil service.
God.
No gratuity, no pension.
And what about Sam?
Sam.
Yeah.
Sam was immediately promoted to take my position.
Jesus Christ.
My son, I think that is enough.